The Ripoff Report site is a well-known resource for consumers. Just type in a name and you can see what anonymous people have to say about a company or a person. But just how reliable is that information?
I don't belong there. We don't do anything illegal. Our company sells a good product and a good service.
If you believe the site, South Beach businessman Michael Zwebner has been connected to the mob and called scum. He's so outraged he filed a lawsuit.
This is a new medium of the internet has allowed for electronic terrorism. That's really what this is.
Zwebner's company sells machines that work like dehumidifiers. They take moisture out of the air and turn it into drinking water. He says after inaccurate information about him appeared on Ripoff Report, the website would not remove it or allow him to respond. He says the site's creator offered to send a reporter to write a positive story about him, but Zwebner would have to pay.
That'll cost you $1,500 plus his expenses and his ass. I'm not paying for any reporter and any expenses.
Zwebner's attorney, Robert Cooper, says the website posts consumer complaints for free, but it doesn't work the same way for businesses.
The companies have to pay to respond.
Hey, Michelle.
Hi.
Steve Miller says he was also targeted by Ripoff Report. Miller runs a debt consolidation company in Deerfield Beach. He believes Ripoff Report has knowingly posted bogus complaints about his company.
I think that somebody's not telling the truth.
Miller says this is a copy of an email from the site's founder, Ed Magidson. He offered Miller what he calls a corporate advocacy program for $2,500 up front and $125 a month. The program promises to turn all the negatives into a positive. Anyone would want to do business with your company. You will wish there were more Ripoff Reports on you. No joke. Miller wasn't laughing, and he wasn't paying.
It's just not going to happen.
And Miller kicked things up a notch. He's offering a $20,000 reward on the internet to anyone who can tell him where to find Ed Magidson, the man behind Ripoff Report. It's easy to find the website, but lawyers have not been able to find Magidson to serve him with the lawsuits.
It's very frustrating. That's the reason for the reward.
Through the website, I was able to contact Ed Magidson by email. He turned down an offer for an interview, but his attorney sent a letter. In part, it reads the lawsuits are frivolous, that Zwebner's claims are blatantly false, and that Steve Miller's company requested a proposal for providing services. Ripoff Report's lawyer points out the site provides a valuable service to consumers by providing a forum for victims. The letter adds the Ripoff Report has never removed a story in exchange for money and has never offered to do so. Magidson's lawyer says the cases don't even belong in Florida, that the company operates out of Arizona. But there is a much bigger issue here. Freedom of speech. Website providers like Ripoff Report are protected from what people post on their sites and are not responsible for the content. Look for lawyers in these cases to argue businesses need more protection.
The government has to start drawing a line there.
In the meantime, cyberspace remains a wealth of information and misinformation, and sometimes it is very difficult to tell the difference. Carmel Cafaro, 7 News.